Hello friends, now we are going to discuss the second numerical, right? That is the numerical 2. Let us read the numerical carefully. In the circuit of figure, at omega t is equal to pi, right? In the circuit of figure, at omega t is equal to pi, V0 of t is blank space they have given. Means it is expected that what is the value of V0 of t? Right, I0 of t blank space. Second, for omega t greater than pi till I0 of t reaches 0, if t1 continues to conduct, it is diode blank space which conducts along with it, and the load voltage is blank space. The blanks are respectively okay, and they have given yes, it is a symmetrical configuration and the half controlled bridge rectifier. Are you getting the point? Okay, one thyristor, one diode, one thyristor, one diode. Okay, Vs is Vm into sine of omega t, right. Now they have asked the specifically questions regarding V0 of t, I0 of t and which diode conducts. Okay. So for this circuit, can we draw the waveform? Yes, we already discussed about this circuit. 0, this is omega t. Suppose this is V0 and next let us draw the I0 as well. Omega t, load they have given it as a RL, right? Load they have given it as a RL, right? So if you check, from omega t is equal to 0 to alpha, alpha to pi, pi to pi plus alpha, and pi plus alpha to 2 pi. Okay, so alpha pi, pi plus alpha 2 pi. Okay, so here the output voltage will be like this. Okay, during alpha to pi, yes, thyristor T1 and D2, right, conducts. So here T1, D2, and from pi to pi plus alpha, whatever the energy stored by the inductor, inductor releases the energy through D4, T1. T1, D4. After that, pi plus alpha to 2 pi. If you check, it is a T2, D4. T2, D4. And here with T2, D2 will be in the conduction mode. Okay, so if you check, yes, for this circuit, right, Vm sin omega t, so here it is a plus, here it is a minus during the positive half cycle. Okay, so if you check, at alpha thyristor T1 will be turned on, so current will be flowing from T1, load, D2 and again back to the Vs. In this loop the current will be flowing, right? So inductor go on storing the energy, right? Inductor go on storing the energy, right? So if you check, at omega t is equal to pi, V0 of t is equal to, if you check at omega t is equal to pi, what is the V0? It is a 0. Okay, so here V0 should be equal to 0, right? V0 is equal to 0. Is this clear? I0 of t we need to find. Okay, so here if you check, if the inductor is high, whether they have specified anything regarding the inductor, no. Okay, so let us consider the inductor is having a lesser value. Okay, so due to that the conduction will be discontinuous. Okay, because they have used the word for omega t greater than pi till I0 of t reaches 0, if T1 continues to conduct, it is diode dash dash which conducts along with it. Okay, so till I0 of t reaches 0 they have said. Okay, I0 is reaching the 0 means what? It is a discontinuous conduction. Okay, so after alpha, what is happening? After alpha, the inductor go on storing the energy. So from alpha to pi, inductor stores the energy, right? And from pi to beta, suppose this is the inductor we are having, okay, lesser value of inductor. Okay, so that's why it is reaching 0 means it is a beta, right? Suppose it is reaching 0 at beta. Okay, so next, so what is the I0 of t? If you check, I0 of t at omega t is equal to pi, at pi I0 of t is positive only. Okay, so at pi I0 of t is a positive. Positive means what? It is a greater than 0. It is a greater than 0, right? I0 of t is greater than 0, right? Next, again after that, what will happen? At pi plus alpha, again inductor stores the energy and here it will be decreasing for the continuous cycle. Okay, so it is a alpha, here it is a pi, beta, pi plus alpha, and here it is a 2 pi. Okay, so next, for the second statement, for omega t greater than pi, means for omega t greater than pi, means after this pi, okay, till I0 of t reaches 0, means till after this instant, till I0 of t reaches 0, that is a beta. Okay, that is a beta. Yes, If T1 continues to conduct, if T1 is continues to conduct, then it is the diode which conducts along with it. Yes, if you check with a T1, diode D4 will be in the conduction mode. Okay. So here, when T1, D2 on state, current flows from supply voltage, T1 load, D2 and again back to the supply voltage, inductor stores the energy. Okay. After pi, what will happen? Supply voltage polarity is reverse, remains plus here and here it is a minus. Okay. So here, the inductor releases the energy through D4 T1, through D4 T1. So with T1, diode D4 will be there. Okay, diode D4, right, which conducts along with it. Is this clear? And the load voltage is, if you check during this interval, means when these two are in the on state, what is the load voltage? Load voltage will be, yes, voltage across the conducting switches is equal to zero. Yes or no, right? So load voltage is zero. Is this clear? So please try to understand the circuit operation. This is a discontinuous conduction. This is a discontinuous conduction. So due to that, what is happening? Yes, inductor is releasing the energy through T1, D4, right? But before applying the gate signal to thyristor T2, right, inductor releases the energy, and whatever the inductor energy becomes zero, right? Before this instant, inductor energy becomes zero. That is at beta. Okay, so here if you check, yes, 0 greater than 0, D4 and 0, 0 greater than 0, D4 and 0. So correct answer is option A. Option A is the correct answer. Is this clear? Are you getting the point? Okay, so this is about the numerical 2. Please try to understand, this is the discontinuous conduction. Okay, means the value of the inductor is lesser. For discontinuous conduction, please try to understand, for discontinuous conduction, beta is always less than pi plus alpha. This is for discontinuous, and for continuous, beta is equal to pi plus alpha. This is for continuous, this one is for discontinuous, right? Beta equal to pi plus alpha means what? Inductor is releasing the energy till pi plus alpha. Okay, so that's why the conduction is continuous, and beta less than pi plus alpha means it is a discontinuous conduction. Okay, in the next video we are going to discuss the third numerical related to the controlled rectifiers. Thank you.